Good morning, students. I welcome you all to a new class in physics today. In today's class, children, we will be solving the numerical problems of exercise 2C. And before I begin with the numericals, I would like to draw your kind attention to the formulae which we are going to use to solve these numerical problems. Okay? Now, these numerical problems are based on equations of motion. Right? Now, there are three equations of motion which I am going to use to solve the numerical problems. The first one is V is equal to U plus AT. The second one is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And the third one is V square minus U square is 2AS. I want you to look at these three equations. These are known as the three equations of motion. I would like to specify over here, children, that U stands for initial velocity or initial speed. V stands for final velocity or final speed. A stands for acceleration. T stands for time. And capital S stands for distance traveled or displacement. You already are aware of all these terms because we have covered them up in the theory. Okay? And we will also be using one more formula, that is average speed is equal to total distance traveled upon total time taken. Right? So as we proceed with the numerical problems of the exercise, you will know about how to substitute the values and how to use these formulae. Okay? Now I begin with the first numerical problem of the exercise. I'll read out the numerical for you. I want you to take out your notebooks, sit and solve the numericals as I solve for you on the board. Right? So, I'm going to read out the first numerical problem of exercise 2C. There are total 15 numericals. I will be covering 7 numericals in the first half and the remaining in the next lecture. I begin with the first numerical. I want you to pay attention, children, and you solve with me. A body starts from rest. Remember, whenever it is mentioned in the statement that body starts from rest, it means it is initial velocity is zero because it is starting from rest. And it covers a uniform acceleration of 2 meters per second square. That is the acceleration which is given. Find the distance covered. You are supposed to find out the value of S when the time given is 2 seconds, right? So, when you are reading the numerical problem, children, while reading the numerical problem, you have to keep on writing the data, okay? This is known as the data and carries marks. Now, here you are supposed to find out the value of S. What were the three equations, children? V is equal to U plus AT. Very quickly, I write down. S is UT plus half AT square. This was the second one. And the third one was V square minus U square is 2AS. Now, I need to find out the value of S. There is no need to use this because there is no S in this equation. I can either use this one or this one, right? I hope you are understanding. Now, here I will use, it's up to me whether I want to use this or this. Okay, now I will use using S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Let's put the values. What is U, children? 0. T is 2 plus half into A is 2 into T is 2 the whole square. See, it is simple substitution and nothing else. What is this? This is 0. I can cancel this. Finally, what do I get? I get S as 4 meters. So, this is my answer. It is very easy. The numericals are not difficult. Calculation is also very simple. The main thing is that you are reading the numerical very carefully and you are deciding on to which formula will you choose to solve the numericals. Please have a look and then we move on to the second numerical problem. We go to the second numerical problem, children. I am erasing this. I hope it's clear. Right? Now, in the second numerical problem, it's a similar kind. Second, I am reading out, a body starts with an initial velocity. Now it is given U to be initial velocity 10 initial velocity is 10 and acceleration is 5 meters per second square. This is given. Find the distance covered, okay, and the time is given to be 5 seconds. Right? Again, it's the same type of numerical. We are going to use the formula S is ut plus half a t square again. I am not solving this numerical for you. I want you to substitute the value. See, you have the value of u, you have the value of t, and you have the value of a. So please substitute the values and calculate the answer on your own. So this is, I am leaving this for you to solve. Okay, so please copy this and then we move on to the third numerical. Okay children, now we move to the third numerical problem. Let us see what is given in the third question. A vehicle is accelerating on a straight road. Its velocity at any instance is 30 kilometers. Let's take the velocity V1 to be 30 kilometers per hour. Right? It is given. After 2 seconds, its velocity changes to 33.6 kilometers per hour. Fine. And again after 2 seconds, so let it be T1, let this be T2. Again there is a new velocity V3 and that is 37.2 kilometers per hour. Right children? So they have given 3 values. You are supposed to find out the acceleration of the vehicle, okay, and you also have to decide whether this acceleration is uniform or not. So you are supposed to answer uniform or non-uniform. What is the acceleration produced? Now this question is slightly different. How? First of all, see children, this is in kilometers per hour and this is in seconds. I told you that the units have to be of the same level. So it means that I need to convert this 2 into hours. So that would be, if I want to convert seconds to hours, I divide by 3600. Okay, because 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. So what will I get children? I get it as 1/18000, right? Similarly, here also it will be 1/18000 hours. Now, what will I do? I have two sets. First, I will take this one, number 1, and then I am going to take this as number 2. Why? Because the formula for acceleration is, what is the formula for acceleration, children? It will be v2 minus v1 upon t1. Why? Why? Because acceleration is change in velocity. See, first the initial velocity was this, final is this, and time is this. So we will substitute these two values over here and we will find out the answer for acceleration 1. Now let us substitute. What is this? This is 33.6 minus 30 upon 1 upon 1800. And that works out to 3.6 upon 1 and this would be into 1800. Okay, so we will get the value of A1. Now what about A2 children? In A2 also, leave it as it is. Let's go to A2, it will be V3 minus V2 upon T2. What is V3 children? It's going to be 37.2 minus 33.6 upon 1 upon 1800. So that will also work out to, what is 37.2 minus 33.6? That works out to, 1 second, 3.6 into 1800 upon 1. So it's the same thing. Can you see? The value of A1 is also working out to 3.6 into 1800. Value of A2 is also working out to be the same. Right? So what does this mean? This means that the value of acceleration in both the cases is same. And as the value of acceleration in both the cases is same, what kind of acceleration would it be? It is uniform acceleration. So the answer is it is uniform acceleration. Right? I hope you understood. Once again, just have a careful look. You have been provided the first speed. After 2 seconds, the new speed. After 2 seconds, the third speed. You are supposed to find out the acceleration in two cases. In the first case, final minus initial upon time. In the second case, final minus initial upon time. And then you have to assess whether the acceleration in both the cases is the same or not. In this case, the acceleration in both the cases works out to be same. So therefore, the acceleration is uniform acceleration. This is question number 3. Now we move on to question number 4. Just have a look at this and then we move on to question number 4. If you want, you can calculate this, children. This value will work out to 0.5. Okay, 0.5. Let's go to the fourth numerical. I'm reading out the fourth numerical problem for you. I want you also to read it from your book as I read it out for you. It is given a body initially at rest, means u is 0, right? Starts moving with a constant acceleration of 2 meters per second square, okay? Calculate the velocity v acquired by the body and the distance traveled in 5 seconds. So you have to find out two things now. It means you are going to use the formula. Two different types of formulas are you going to put here. Now let's see. If I use the first equation, v is equal to u plus at, can I find out the value of v? Let me see. Yes, I can. So what will I do? V is equal to u plus a into t. So what is my answer? 10 meters per second. Simple, direct. I used the first equation of motion and I found out the value of the final velocity. Now I want to find out the value of s. I use the formula ut plus half a t square. Okay, let me substitute. S is equal to u into t plus half into a into t square. Yes, now what is this, children? 0 plus 25, and my answer works out to 25 meters. So I am able to find out both the value of v by using v is equal to u plus at and the value of s by using formula s is equal to ut plus half at square. See, I have used the two equations of motion and found out the answer. Okay, fine. Now let's move on to question number 5. Let's move on to question number 5, children. Now in question number 5, I'll read out the question. A bullet initially moving with the velocity, that is u, is 20 meters per second, that is given to you, and strikes a target and comes to rest. Now it comes to rest afterwards, later on. So v is 0. And after penetrating a distance of 10 centimeters, that is the distance given, you are supposed to calculate the retardation. Okay? Now, what is the meaning of the word retardation? It is negative acceleration, children. If you remember, I have taught you that negative acceleration, that is when a body is already moving with the velocity and after some time it stops. Or its final velocity becomes 0, then it is retarded. Okay? Now you can see this is meters and this is centimeters. It needs to be converted. You have to be very, very careful. It is 0.1 meters. This I have done the conversion. Now, if I want to find out the value of r, can I use s is equal to ut plus half at square, children? Think. Can I use this? Do I have the value of t? Can you see over here? No, it means I cannot use this particular formula. Then what should I use? I can use v square minus u square is equal to s. Yes, this could be used perhaps. How? 0 square minus 20 the whole square is equal to 2 into, in place of a, you can write down r, into s. Right? See, I have put all the values. What do I get? Minus 400 is equal to 0.2 R. Right? Now, what is R then, children? It would be minus 400 upon 0.2, which would work out to 4000 minus 4000 upon 2. And when I cancel, it comes to minus 2000 meters per second square. Now listen, important to note, when I get my answer as negative, it's correct. Why? Because it is negative acceleration. But I have to represent it in, I can write this answer in two ways. Either I can say my answer is, see, I'll write it down here. Either I would say my answer is A is minus 2000 meters per second square, or I could write it as R is equal to 2000 meters per second square. Both are correct. Why not negative over here? Because retardation itself is negative acceleration, right? So when I write acceleration, I have to show the sign. But when I write retardation, I need not put the negative sign, right? So it is, both the answers are correct. This is question number 5. Let's hurry up and we move to the 6th numerical problem. Just have a careful look how I have solved. Now we move on to the 6th numerical problem. Okay, children, I hope you are able to understand how to solve and how to represent. Now we move on to the 6th numerical problem. A train moving with a velocity, so u is 20 meters per second, okay, is brought to rest, children, brought to rest, V0, by applying brakes in 5 seconds. So that's the time given. You are supposed to calculate the retardation. Again, we are supposed to calculate V is equal to U plus AT. Yes, we can use this. So 0 is equal to 20 plus R into 5, right? So let me take this 20 the other side, it becomes minus 20 is 5R. Or I could say R is equal to minus 20 by 5, which I would write as 4 plus 4, children, because it's R, remember. Or my answer would be A is equal to minus 4 meters per second square. So I told you, if I write it as R, it would be positive. But if I write it as A, it would be negative. Clear, children? This has to be always kept in mind. This is the 6th numerical problem. Right? So, let's move on very quickly to the last numerical problem today. That is the 7th numerical problem. Okay? I'm erasing this. I'll start with the 7th numerical problem. What is given? In 7th, it is given a train travels with a speed of 60 kilometers from station A to station B. It is moving 60 kilometers per hour, right? And from B to A, back. From B to A, it is moving with 80 kilometers. So there are two speeds at which it is moving. And you are supposed to find out the average speed and the average velocity. First of all, I'll pick up the easy one. Let's find out what's the average velocity. You know, children, here in this case, the average velocity will be 0. Why will it be 0? Do you remember? I told you that when the starting point and the ending point is the same, the velocity is 0. So therefore, you say, because start point and end point are the same. So therefore, average velocity is 0. Now let us look at average speed. The formula for average speed, I told you, is total distance traveled. It could be S1 plus S2 upon total time taken, T1 plus T2. But we don't know the time in this case. We only know the distance. We only know the speed. What are we going to do? Let us suppose the distance is x kilometers. Right? So what am I going to do? I'm going to say, in case 1, right? It is speed is equal to distance upon time. What is the speed here? 60 is equal to x upon t1. And therefore, what is t1, children? What would be t1? X by 60. Right? See, in this case, speed is distance upon time. Time is x by, that is distance upon speed. Now, similarly, for case 2, in case 2 also, v2 is x upon t2. Right? Let me put the values. In here it would be 80 is x upon t2, and therefore what is t2, children? It would be x by 80. So now I substitute. See, I got the value of t1, I got the value of t2, I will substitute here. What is distance, children? X plus x upon time, x upon 60 plus x upon 80. See, I have calculated the time and I have put here. That would be 2x upon, I solve this, children, 60 and 80 is 240, LCM is 240. 6 4s are 24. 6 4s are, so this would be 4x plus 8 3s are. Let me solve 2x upon 7x upon 240. That would be 2x into 240 upon 7x. X will cancel. And when I solve this entire thing, my answer will come as 68.57 kilometers per hour. Please check it out, children. I want you to solve this also and see for yourselves. The answer will work out to 68.57, and that's the correct answer, children. It's a lengthy question though, but you are supposed to understand it. See, average velocity is zero because the starting and the ending is the same. What about the average speed? Total distance upon total time. We don't know the total time. So we will first find out time 1 and time 2 and then substitute it over here. And we are supposing that the distance is x. It is same in both the cases because it is from A to B and B to A. After calculations, we get the value of average speed as 68.57 kilometers per hour. So with this, we solve 7 questions of this exercise 2C. In the next lecture, I will be solving the remaining questions. I want you to go through these numericals, and you all are going to solve this and practice them in your files. Okay, children? Thank you.